Laws of exponents of real numbers will be discussed in this part. These laws will be very useful for your exercise 1.6. So let's start. Laws of exponents. Let a greater than 0 be a real number. A here is greater than 0 and a real number, and p and q be rational numbers. Then we have the following identities. First is a raised to the power p multiplied by a raised to the power q is equals to a raised to the power p plus q. This is the first identity. When the bases are same and powers are different and they are in multiplication, we use this identity. Suppose 2 raised to the power 3 multiplied by 2 raised to the power 2. How will solve it easily? 3 plus 2. 2 raised to the power 5, which is equals to 32. In this way, this identity is applicable. Next is a raised to the power p whole raised to the power q, which is equals to a raised to the power p multiplied by q. Suppose we are given a as 2. Its raised to the power is 2 and it is 3. How will solve it? 2 3s are 6 in this way, which is equals to 64. Next is a raised to the power p divided by a raised to the power q is equals to a raised to the power p minus q. Jab multiplication mein ho, in that case we use the first identity of addition, and when there is in division, we will apply here a difference. So how to apply this? 2 raised to the power 3 divided by 2 raised to the power 2, we'll get 2 raised to the power 3 minus 2. 2 raised to the power 1, 2 is the answer. Then fourth identity is a raised to the power p multiplied by b raised to the power p is equals to ab whole raised to the power p. This identity mein we have different bases but same powers. So we will apply this as our law. Suppose 2 raised to the power 2 multiplied by 3 raised to the power 2. 2 3 is a 6. 6 whole raised to the power 2, which is equals to 36. Next is a raised to the power 0 is equals to 1. A yahan pe humne specify kar diya tha starting mein, a must be greater than 0 and it must be a real number. So suppose a is 590 raised to the power 0, it will be 1. Any number which is greater than 0 and a real number, if its power is 0, the answer will be 1. Next is a upon b whole raised to the power m is equals to b upon a whole raised to the power m. Jab humne bracket ke andar jo hamara division tha, a upon b tha, uska reciprocal ho jayega and negative power will be converted into positive power. Suppose here it is 1 upon 2 whole raised to the power minus 2. So we can write it like this, 2 raised to the power 2. 2 upon 1 is 2. Our answer is 4. In this way, this law is applicable. So these are the laws of exponents. Next is, in the language of exponents, we define this expression as a raised to the power 1 upon m. This will be more clear with an example. There are two ways to look at 4 raised to the power 3 upon 2. The laws which we have studied, that is also applicable, and this expression can also be applied. 4 raised to the power 3 upon 2. We can write it like this. 4, 1 upon 2 and 3 like this, because a raised to the power p ka whole raised to the power q hota hai, so it will be 3 upon 2. So when we'll apply this law here, how it will be converted? N ko hum likh denge 1 upon n. Yahan pe 1 upon n ki form mein 1 upon 2 hai. So hum kaise likh denge? Root 4 and here as 2 raised to the power 3. What is root 4? 2. 2 raised to the power 3, which is equals to 8. This is the one way. And the second way is 4 raised to the power 3 upon 2 ko solve kaise karenge? We will do the prime factorization of 4. That is 2 into 2 means 2 raised to the power 2 whole raised to the power 3 upon 2. We will multiply these both. What we'll get? 2 into 3 upon 2. 2 will be cut here. What we'll get? Simply 2 raised to the power 3, which is also equals to 8, and answer is same. So in this way, this expression can be used in different exponents. So I hope these concepts must be clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can comment in comment section. Next part, we'll discuss exercise 1.6.